Rev up your engines! Today I'm going to talk about rust in your car, how you can prevent it from destroying your car. Years ago, a guy was trying to sell me on this device that says, hey, just like in a boat, you can hook this up on your car and it'll keep your car from rusting. It sounded like a good idea to me, but I asked an engineer friend, would that work? And he said, no, Scotty, it won't work unless your car is floating in the water. Because it would have to be floating in the water the whole time in order for that process to keep the steel and iron from rusting on your car. So unless you have one of those crazy old German car boats that would drive on the land and then go in the water and drive around, that's not gonna help you, and would only help those when they were in the water. Once they got out of the water, they'd still rust. Rust is gonna occur more with salt water. It's bad news for you people up north where they salt the roads in the winter. You don't slip on ice, it makes the freezing point go lower. Only to a certain point. Eventually it's gonna turn to ice anyways. And for you people who live really close to salt water, like here in Galveston on the Gulf Coast. I had an old photographer on television and he had a house right on the water. His Chrysler rotted to the frame after 4 years. The doors that slid back and forth, all that, even though it was aluminum, it corroded like mad too, because the salt water is gonna do serious damage. Now, if you live further inland, you're not gonna be affected by that all that often. If you live right on a beach, or if you're one of those guys that live somewhere where you can drive on the beach through the water in your car, believe me, don't do it if you don't want your car to rot away. Now, of course, if you ever get your car in a salty condition like that, you want to rinse it off as soon as possible. You want to do the under, the inside, any place where water can get inside and pool up. If that salt water stays in there, it'll start corroding away. But here's one caveat. Let's say you go to a car wash and let them rinse it off. Make sure they're not using recycled water, because a lot of the recycled water in car wash has a reasonable amount of salt in it. So make sure that they use fresh water when they do a rinse. And if you live up north where there's salt in the roads a bunch, well, you want to rinse that off. But here's something that might sound counterintuitive, even though it isn't. You don't want to park your car inside a heated garage. It's not the salt that eats through, it's the salt water. When it's frozen on the car, it's not doing any damage at all. But once it melts, then the salt water gets in and starts rotting things. My mother lives in Buffalo, New York. She got a 14-year-old Toyota Corolla, not a spot of rust on it. She doesn't even own a garage. I grew up in a house that didn't have a garage, even though my father ran a Texaco garage, rather ironic there. But her car sits out in the cold driveway in Buffalo all year long, but it doesn't have any rust on it. She's leaving it when it's really cold. The salt's on the car, but it's not doing any damage. Doesn't do any damage until it melts and then mixes with the water and then starts corroding stuff. So now you know, if you live up north, don't take your car in and out of heated garages all the time. That'll make the thing rot faster. You get any tiny little scratch on your car, touch it up. You don't want the bare metal to stick out and start to rust. You could have either the touch-up paint or even just clear lacquer. Touch it up with that as long as it's sealed and water can't get to the bare metal, it's not gonna do any damage. Now here again, the name of the game is preventing the rust. Because once it starts, pretty much you're screwed. If you just say you have a rusty frame and you start putting undercoating on it, that isn't gonna help. You just seal the stuff in it, it'll continue to rot. You wanna prevent it from rotting in the first place. By protecting the paint, it's shielding all car, just like your skin is keeping bacteria from getting in your body and killing you. Waxing your car prevents rust. Do it in the beginning of the spring, beginning of the summer, beginning of the fall, and the beginning of the winter. And of course, generally, beginning of the winter, you got it, because later in the winter, if it's really cold, you don't want to go out and wax it anyway. And now we come to a type of rust. It really doesn't mean anything, even though it looks bad. It's called surface rust. When only the little exterior part has rust on it, it isn't gonna hurt anything.
Look in here. You can see all this surface rust. Look at it, shining away orange. It means nothing.
In this case, those are the parts of the brake rotor that the brake pads don't touch. So you have bare steel. Of course it's gonna get surface rust on it, but it's thick steel and it means nothing. Structurally, it's perfectly sound. And just like if you go under a car and you see a little surface rust on the frame, get a hammer and hit it. And if still clang, 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 still perfectly fine. In that case, you could clean it off and paint it with a little coating to get rid of the surface rust if you don't like it. But if you hit it and it went koosh and dent holes and got crushed, you'd know the frame was rotting and it was time to say goodbye to your car.
Aluminum often gets surface corrosion on it too, like this. You can see it. It means absolutely nothing. It's just superficial corrosion. Unless you're some kind of fanatic like me and you're polishing the aluminum all the time on the side of your motorcycle, a little surface rust or corrosion on aluminum, that doesn't mean anything. But if you're a fanatic, say with a high-end car like a Porsche, you guys will put painted rotors and stuff on it. But don't do what one of my customers once did. He painted the whole rotor. Of course, you don't paint the part that the brake pads squeeze. He did, and man, he's lucky he didn't kill himself when he went out and hit the brakes the first time it started to slide all over the place. He towed it into me, and I got some paint remover, and I stripped it all off of him. So remember, rust, hey, it's created by iron and oxygen, water, and it's accelerated by salt and water that makes it more electrically conductive. And just like people aging, you can try to slow it down, but you can't stop it. Slow it down as much as possible by keeping a good coating on steel and iron products so they don't start to seriously rust. And as I said, the absolute best preventative is to keep your car waxed without scratches on it and to rinse it at least once a week. Salt water can pool in all kinds of parts. You gotta do a serious rinse. Go to one of those car washes with a wand and rinse everything, all the drains. You gotta get rid of any place where water can pool, then create a salt water environment. Or you could just move to Phoenix, Arizona, where it hardly ever rains. There's no salt and it's dry as can be. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.